Today we are going to discuss adrenal glands and its disorders, hyperfunctioning, with various problems it causes. So let us understand what adrenal glands first, some points about anatomy and few points, related points. Adrenal glands, also called supraadrenal glands. There are two adrenal glands, one on each side of, situated above the kidney. That's why it is called supraadrenal glands. The glands has got outer area glands, it's called cortex. Inner part of the gland is called adrenal medulla. Now, adrenal cortex has got further three zones. One is zona glomerulosa, that secretes mineralocorticoids, that's aldosterone. Zona fasciculata secretes glucocorticoids. Zona reticularis, it secretes sex hormones. Now, adrenal medulla, inner part of the adrenal gland, it produces catecholamines and their excess leading to pheochromocytoma. Adrenal cortex and their hormones secreted by it, they are mainly regulated by hypothalamo-pituitary-adrenal axis. That means, if the hormone secreted by glucocorticoids from zona fibrosa is less, then it stimulates hypothalamus and pituitary to secrete hormone through their releasing hormone or ACTH. Whereas mineralocorticoid zona glomerulosa is mainly, it's a renin angiotensin system which regulates it, how much aldosterone should be secreted. Depend on the sodium and water level. Now, we'll discuss first hypofunction of adrenal glands. Here, or otherwise called as a adrenal insufficiency, depending on site of lesion, divided into two types: primary adrenocortical insufficiency, secondary adrenocortical insufficiency. Primary adrenal insufficiency is popularly otherwise called Addison's disease. We'll discuss this later. Actually, here there is a failure of adrenal gland itself, problem with adrenal glands. The cause could be idiopathic, mostly. Or can be because of autoimmune disorders, can be because of hemorrhage, infections. Yes. TB, 80% time it can be because of this TB tuberculosis. AIDS disorders, meningococcal septicemia. Sometimes secondaries, sometimes surgical removal will cause hypofunctioning, or hemochromatosis, amyloidosis, etc. Whereas secondary adrenal insufficiency, due to failure of ACTH production or release, First classic example is hypopituitarism. Second, very important is suppression of hypothalamic pituitary axis by long-term steroid use. Those who are using steroid for long term, long periods, weeks and months, suppose suddenly they stop this, then they will cause, so because of the suppressed axis, this adrenal insufficiency occurs. Now we'll talk about Addison's disease as such. Addison's disease, I already mentioned the causes. Addison's disease, or otherwise called primary adrenocortical insufficiency. Here, what do you find? It is characterized by hypofunctioning of adrenal cortex, where more than 90% gland is destroyed. Then it occurs. Sex-wise, is more in female, 2:1 ratio. Age group, usually middle-aged. Clinical features. Onset. Usually it's a chronic onset, but sometimes there is acute adrenal insufficiency. It's called Addisonian crisis. So the Addisonian crisis we'll talk later. So clinical features, there will be generalized weakness, asthenia, wasting, weight loss, various GI symptoms. There are anorexia, loss of appetite with nausea, vomiting, sometimes abdominal pains. Sometimes diarrhea. Many times, very peculiar to it is pigmentation of skin and mucous membrane. Bluish, black, dusky brown, discoloration of lips, gums, inside of cheeks, buccal mucosa, tongue, palate, many times face, neck, genitalia, dorsum of hands, creases of hands, they are pigmented, hyperpigmented, they become black. Now this pigmentation is due to disturbance of tyrosine metabolism, which is being converted into melanin. On examination, you also find hypotension, low blood pressure. This is totally below 90. Pulse weak. Many times patients say giddiness. Now investigations. Here investigations. Plasma cortisol levels are low. Serum sodium and chloride, they are low. Serum potassium is increased. ACTH levels are low. ACTH levels are very high. Adrenal antibodies present in autoimmune disorders. Chest X-ray shows sometime tuberculosis in the lungs. Plain X-ray abdomen or CT abdomen will show calcification in adrenal glands. Management. First, treat the underlying cause. If tuberculosis is there, treat it. Very important thing is replacement of glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids lifelong, as the gland is totally destroyed. Replacement of steroids very important. 2/3 of dose is given morning time, 1/3 in evening time. Oral prednisolone 20 mg in the morning, 10 mg in the evening, to be continued during stress time. This dose has to be increased. That's why any type patient who is, you have to take the history. Patient taking chronic steroids and you want to do some surgery or some procedure and you ask steroid suddenly, then there will be a lot of problems. Now mineralocorticoids, orally fludrocortisone 0.05 to 1 mg per day, or injection form DOCA, deoxycorticosterone acetate, 2 to 5 mg intramuscularly can be given. Also, all the time patient should be advised to educate salt so their BP is maintained. Monitoring is done by measurement of plasma renin and plasma cortisol level. This is about chronic adrenal insufficiency or Addison's disease. Now what about the acute adrenal insufficiency, otherwise called Addisonian crisis? Addison's crisis or acute adrenal insufficiency many times occurs. So there is a sudden development of adrenal failure leads to this crisis, and it's an acute medical emergency. Causes: severe infections, acute gastroenteritis, surgical operations, trauma, septicemia, or mainly sudden withdrawal of steroids. Clinical features: there are severe degree of prostrations, extreme weakness, vomiting, diarrhea many times, patient in the state of shock, hypotension, is not attended emergency as emergency treatment not given, patient may pass into coma, death may result. Here the treatment in acute adrenal insufficiency or Addisonian crisis is, MF treatment is 3, to increase the blood pressure, second, correct fluid balance, third is very important, is prevent hypoglycemia. So such acute adrenal insufficiency cases, you have to admit, give 10% of glucose saline IV hydrocortisone given, 200 mg or more, repeated 6th hourly. If there is an infection is the cause, then give broad spectrum antibiotic suitably. Now once patient recovers, then oral steroids are given. This is about hypofunction of adrenal glands. Now we'll discuss hyperfunction of adrenal glands. Here hyperfunctioning adrenal gland, there are few more things. There are 3 syndromes. One is Kahn's syndrome, or hyperaldosteronism. Second is Cushing syndrome, where there is a hypercortisol state, or when the sex hormones are more than adrenal virilism. Here, we will talk about Cushing syndrome first. It's a hypercortisol state result from excess production of cortisol by adrenal cortex, resulting in various symptom signs of this syndrome. Causes. Two types of causes. ACTH dependent, more than 80% of cases. Second is ACTH independent, 20% of cases. In ACTH dependent, adrenal hyperplasia due to pituitary micro or microadenoma, called Cushing's disease. Or ectopic ACTH production by various tumors of the body. So tumors of the body, lungs or other places, they produce ACTH like protein, produce ACTH and its effect. Second category is ACTH independent, 20% of cases where problem in the adrenal gland itself. So adrenal adenoma, adrenal carcinoma. Third important thing is iatrogenic due to administration of steroids for long periods for certain diseases. We give steroids, but patient continues to take without any medical advice, then he develops the syndrome. Prolonged use of steroids. Now, clinical features of Cushing syndrome. So here, symptoms are weight gain, obesity, hirsutism, menstrual irregularity, extreme muscle weakness, psychological changes, depression, many times blackening of skin. Here, very typical obesity occurs, called central obesity and thin extremity. Described as a lemon on a stick. Fat deposition in the face and interscapular areas. Where the patient looks like moon faces and buffalo hump. Other things will be, signs will be edema, high blood pressure, hypertension, scanty menses, and cutaneous stri, purple stri over abdomen and thighs, easy bruisability due to brittle skin, acne, fractures very common, osteoporosis very common, emotional lability, personality changes, many times hypokalemic alkalosis, apart from pigmentation. There is a tendency to increase infections. The tendency to have high blood sugar, hyperglycemia, impaired wound healing. So many things occurs. Investigations. Plasma cortical levels is increased. Dexamethasone suppression test we carry out. We give 0.5 mg dexamethasone 6 hourly for 48 hours. So there is an inadequate suppression of plasma cortisol and urinary free cortisol. This will confirm the diagnosis. Low level of ACTH. If you measure acid levels are low, suggest adrenal adenoma or malignancy. High levels of ACTH suggest problem with the pituitary. So pituitary adenoma. Then other thing is ectopic ACTH. ACTH secreted elsewhere in the body from various tumors. MRF brain for detecting pituitary tumors. Chest and abdomen scanning done to localize ectopic ACTH secreting tumors. Now treatment. Treat the underlying cause. Adrenal tumors, then surgical resection. Pituitary tumors. So also surgical resection. Many time we require radiotherapy for that. Those who are not responding to surgery or pituitary tumor, give radiotherapy, radiation therapy. Sources of ectopic ACTH tumors are excised. They are found. If excision cannot be possible, then bilateral total adrenalectomy done surgically or medical treatment. They give metirapone, this is medicine. This drug inhibits corticosteroid synthesis. That's how we treat the cases. So, Cushing's disease, not a rare entity. You see in the wards, everywhere you find these cases. Now, we talk about Kahn's syndrome or hyperaldosteronism. Here, there is overproduction of aldosterone, that's why it is called hyperaldosteronism. It's a major sodium retaining hormone. Two types. Primary hyperaldosteronism is called Kahn's syndrome. There is a problem in the adrenal gland itself. Secondary hyperaldosteronism, this occurs because of extra adrenal stimulus for renin secretion is present. Example is renal artery stenosis, diuretic therapy, liver cirrhosis. Well, this occurs. Secondary hyperaldosteronism. Now we talk about Kahn's syndrome, otherwise called primary hyperaldosteronism. Causes in itself is the adenoma, adrenal adenoma, or there is a bilateral hyperplasia of zona globulosa. Maybe idiopathic, maybe genetic, autosomal dominant. Clinical features. There is a water and sodium retention leads to hypertension in this condition, and patient develops edema. These are classic clinical features. Second thing is loss of potassium. Aldosterone will cause loss of potassium, leads to hypokalemia, resulting in hypokalemia and metabolic alkalosis. Thereby, patient will have severe muscle weakness, difficult to walk, abdomen distension. Sometimes patient develops condition called periodic muscle paralysis, polyuria, sometimes tetany, etc. Investigations. Triad of these three investigations where plasma potassium is low, plasma or urinary aldosterone levels are very high. Third point of the triad is increased plasma renin activity. If these are there, it establishes the diagnosis. Other test, of course, in Cohn syndrome is do abdominal scan or CT scan for adenoma. How do you manage this Cohn syndrome or primary hyperaldosteronism? Patient has got hypertension, patient has got hypokalemia. This has to be managed. Spironolactone, this diuretic is a anti-aldosterone diuretic. High doses are given, 200 to 400 mg per day, divide dose. One of the side effects of this spironolactone diuretic is gynecomastia, development of breast in male. One can add ACE inhibitors, this anti-hypertensive drug. Examples of ACE inhibitors are Remiplil, Lisinopril, or some suppose tumors are adenoid tumors are there, then surgery is recommended. Unilateral adenectomy is preferred choice, give 60% case cure. So I have discussed hyperfunctioning, of the adrenal glands, very popular disease, Addison's disease I discussed, Cushing's disease I discussed, and Cohn syndrome. This adrenal gland is a gland of emergency. So various interesting features. Here, certain photographs of adrenal glands system is very interesting in endocrine diseases. Clinical examinations, very interesting. So you have to go for height and weight, make out dwarfism or gigantism. One can go for acromegalic hands, pigmentation of creases, sometimes carpal tunnel syndrome, skin you find pigmentations, striae, thickness, pulse record many times, you find a slow pulse or tachycardia, more so in hyperthyroidism, bradycardia and hypothyroidism. Regarding blood pressure, classically one of the cause of hypertension, secondary hypertension is Kahn's syndrome. Hypertension do occur in Cushing syndrome, pheochromocytoma, examination head, Graves disease. You find diplopia, ophthalmoplegia, hairs, alopecia, various facial features of hypothyroidism. Prognathism, you can see in acromegaly. Voice, hoarse voice you see in hypothyroidism. Thyroid gland, you can see goiter, diffuse. This is multinodular goiter. Diffuse goiter. You see in Graves' disease. Then you find the body fat distribution. Central obesity in Cushing syndrome. Bones, fragility, fractures you see in hyperparathyroidism. Legs, myxedema and hypothyroidism. Proximal myopathy, pre-tibial myxedema in Graves' disease. So also in Graves' disease, you can see this lady staring looks. You can see the upper eyelid is retracted up. So she has got exophthalmos, proptosis, staring looks. This is Graves' disease. The CT scan and other things also show this. There is a bilateral ophthalmopathy, diplopia and so many things. So endocrine disorders with these facial features, you can easily make out that patient has got hyperthyroidism. Whereas in myxedema, very puffy face and all that, loss of eyebrows and eyebrows and all that, puffy, dull looking person is hypothyroidism. Whereas in Cushing syndrome, I said lemon on a stick, central obesity and all that. So Addison's disease, black pigmented body, thick, frail, weak person. So endocrine system is very interesting. Simple observation of case will make think of a clinical diagnosis and further establishment of various clinical features, investigations to throw light on the cause. So endocrine system is the one system where patient as a spotter we have to look. That will give a lot of information. I think with this I will rest my class.